The new UV Primer Collection contains everything you need to perform fast, reliable repairs. This short video will be going over the best practices for the UV Primer Collection to give you safe, reliable results. To begin, you'll need to ensure that you have all of the necessary safety equipment. Despite the lack of heat and its cool blue appearance, the UV lamp gives off light very similar to natural sunlight, which means it can harm your skin and eyes if not handled properly. Because of this, you'll need the following: 6mm UV protective gloves, UV protective glasses shade number 5, a full body paint suit, and a respirator or fresh air hood to ensure your protection. For personal safety, never look directly into the UV light or shine it at others, and ensure that the UV light is off when not in use to limit exposure time. For best results, your surface will need to be prepared before application. Wash all surfaces to be painted with soap and water, then apply the appropriate substrate cleaner. This substrate should be thoroughly cleaned and dried both before and after application. Next, finish sanded bare metal areas with 180 grit abrasive. Do not apply etch primer before UV priming. SUA 1080 is a direct-to-metal product. Sand old finishes with 320 to 400 grit dry by hand or machine, or 600 grit if wet. Once that's done, wash away any residue with a tack rag. If your surface is aluminum or stainless substrate, be sure to prime within 8 hours of surface prep. AdPro SUA 470LV or SU470LV needs to be applied prior to application of UV primer on all raw exposed plastic areas. For carbon steel, you'll need to prime immediately after prep to get best results. You'll optimize your results even further if you keep repair projects to roughly a 6-inch circle or less. Now that you're suited up and your surface is prepared, you're ready to spray. Be sure to agitate the mix thoroughly by shaking the can vigorously for 1 minute after the mixing ball rattles to ensure uniformity and to prevent clogging. For even better results, only use in environments that are at least 70 degrees Fahrenheit or around 20 degrees Celsius. Apply multiple wet coats using continuous passes. You should be at around 1 mil for every 3 or 4 wet coats. If you aren't seeing much change, don't worry. UV primer is clear with some effect pigmentation to visually assist with application, and you should never attempt to spray to hiding. Once finished, don't forget to hold the can upside down and spray until the valve is cleared. You'll need a flash cure immediately after the final coat is applied. Like we mentioned earlier, it's important to have the proper PPE for UV protection, so be sure to have your gloves and safety glasses on hand for this part. There are two ways to cure. You can mount the light so it's stable 4 to 8 inches from your repair area, which is best for areas of around 6 inches, or you can move the light by hand with slow, even passes 3 to 4 inches from the repair area, which is best for areas of around 8 to 12 inches. After curing, clean the repair area with XXA 1081 UV cleaner to remove all film residue. Like SUA 1080, SXA 1081 is ready to spray, so just shake the can vigorously to mix and apply an even layer of cleaner to prime a repair area and wipe clean. All of the products seen in this best practices guide are available through PPG, so just mention what you need to your jobber and they'll be able to get you going. Now that you've become familiarized with the best practices for the use of the UV Primer Collection, you're ready to get to work. Be sure to keep a close eye out for other best practices videos in this series.